science lip test. Okay, portion for science lip test is chapter 1 digestive system, chapter 2 respiratory system. So now onwards you prepare well. In the last class I introduced the new chapter, that is chapter number 3, adaptation in plants and animals. In that you learn about habitat and its types and adaptation. Okay, one time we recall it and we move on to the new topic. Okay, what is mean by habitat? Habitat is nothing but place where an organism lives naturally is called habitat. Okay, what's my habitat? Habitat is a place where an organism lives naturally is called habitat. Okay, the habitat should provide water, food, shelter to the organism. Then only the organism able to live in the habitat. Okay, so the habitat contain two types of components. Rather, two types of components: biotic components and abiotic components. Okay, so biotic components are plants, animals, and microorganisms. Okay, what are the biotic components? All the living things comes under biotic components. Example: plants, animals, and microorganisms. Microorganisms are nothing but virus, bacteria. These are the example for microorganisms. Then abiotic components. Okay, all non-living things are comes under abiotic components. Example: soil, air, water, and sunlight. These are the example for abiotic components. Then types of habitat. Okay, what's the next topic? Types of habitat. We are classified the habitat into two types. One is terrestrial habitat, another one is aquatic habitat. Okay, terrestrial means habitat on land is called terrestrial habitat. Next one is aquatic habitat. Habitat in water is called aquatic habitat. Again, we classify the terrestrial habitat into five types. Okay, first one is forest, second one is desert, third one is grassland, fourth one is hills and mountain, fifth one is polar region. Okay, what are the five types of terrestrial habitat? Forest, desert, grassland, hills and mountain, and polar region. Okay, do you know very well about forest? No. Forest is composed of trees and plants. Okay, there are many different kinds of plants and trees. Understood? So what are the animals lives in the forest? Okay, king cobras, tigers, some of the birds live in the forest. What are the plants live in the forest? Orchids, vines, mosses, ferns. These are the plants that live in the forest. Then next one, desert. If you see the desert, it is fully covered with sand. Okay, desert is fully covered with sand. If you see the climate of the desert, it is very hot during the day and it is very cool during the night. Okay, what are the animals living in the desert? Camel, rattle snake, then some kind of rat are living in the desert. Okay, what are the plants grow on the desert? Cactus, some thorny plants will grow on the desert. Next one, grassland. Okay, grassland are areas that is fully covered with grasses, some trees and shrubs. Okay, if you see the climatic condition of the grassland, they are windy and dry. Next one, what are the animals found here? Tiger, zebra, lion, giraffe, these are the animals found in the grassland. Then next one, hills and mountain. Okay, see, if you see the hills and mountains, they are higher in altitudes. What's my altitude? They are placed above and high in sea level. They are somewhat high above the sea level. Then what are the animals found in this mountain region? Mountain goat, sheep, yak, these are the animals found in this hills and mountain. Then polar region. Okay, this region is fully covered with snow. You see the climatic condition, they are very cool. Okay, what are the animals found here? Polar bear and penguin are found in this polar region habitat. Understood? Then aquatic habitat. What is the next one? Aquatic habitat. Habitat in water is called aquatic habitat. We are classifying the aquatic habitat into three types. One is marine habitat, another one is freshwater habitat, then estuaries. Okay, marine habitat is nothing but salty water habitat. Marine habitat is called salty water habitat. It comes under ocean and seas. Okay, this marine habitat is the home for many plants and animals. What are the animals found in this marine habitat? Fish, okay, crabs, These are the animals found in the marine habitat. If you see the freshwater habitat, it include river, pond, streams. These are included in the freshwater habitat. If you see the animals, fish, frog are living in this freshwater habitat. Lotus, lily are the plants that grow on the freshwater habitat. Then estuaries. Estuaries are nothing but these are the coastal region where salty water from the sea meets the fresh water from the stream. Okay, so what are the animals found here? Horseshoe crabs are found in this estuaries. Okay, see, next one is adaptation. Okay, what is my adaptation? Special features developed by an organism to live in a particular habitat is called adaptation. For example, a fish lives only in water. Okay, like that, camel lives only in the desert. They are not able to live in the thick forest because they have the adaptation to live only in the desert. Camel have the adaptation to live only in the desert. You see the fish also, fish have the some kind of habits, adaptation to live in the water. Understood? So today we are going to see about the terrestrial animals. Okay, in the adaptation in desert animals. Okay, what are terrestrial animals? Animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. Okay, what are terrestrial animals? Animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. Okay, so what's my adaptation? Special features developed by an organism to live in a particular habitat is called adaptation. So now we are going to see about adaptation in desert animal. Okay, which is called the sheep of the desert? Camel. Okay, which is called sheep of the desert? Camel. Okay, camel is called sheep of the desert. Okay, what are the animals found in that desert? Camel, rattlesnake, then kangaroo rat. These are the animals found in the desert. If you see the camel, they have long eyelashes. Okay, what are the adaptation they have means camel? They have long eyelashes and thick eyebrows to prevent the sand entering from the eyes. Okay, you know about the desert climate condition. It is very hot during the day and very cold during the night. It is fully, the desert is fully covered with sand. If it is heavy wind blows, the sand particles also come along with the air. Okay, so in order to prevent the sand entering into the eyes, camel have long eyelashes and thick eyebrows. Okay, then next one, they can close their nostrils to prevent the sand entering from their nose. Okay, what is my nostrils? In the last second chapter, I explain now. What is my nostrils? The holes in the nose. Through this way only air enter into the nose. This is called nostrils. They can close their nostrils to prevent the sand from entering the nose. Okay, while heavy wind blow, that time sand also will enter into the nose. In order to prevent the sand entering into the nose, they have the ability to close their nostrils. The next one is, they have long legs. Okay, camels have long legs which keep the camel away from the hot sand. Okay, then in the desert, the climate is very very hot during the day. So while you are walking on the sand, camel feels somewhat hot. Okay, in order to escape from the extreme hot, they have long leg. Okay, that long leg keep the camel away from the hot sand. Okay, next one is, they have padded feet. Okay, they have padded feet. What is the next one? Camel have padded feet which help the camel to walk easily on the sand. Can you walk on the sand? How do you feel? It is very easy to walk on the sand. No. Okay, we feel somewhat difficult to walk on the sand. Why? If we are walking on the sand, our feet, our leg will go or sink inside the soil or sand. Okay, so we cannot walk easily. Okay, but if you see the camel, they have padded feet. Okay, what's my padded? The camel feet, okay, each foot has cushioned layer like a pad. Okay, that helps that camel to easily walk on the sand. Okay, that pad makes the camel stable by spreading its body weight to each hoof. So easily camel walk on the sand. So the camel have padded feet which help them to walk easily on the sand. Next one, camels drink large amount of water at a time. Okay, why it is why you want to drink a lot of water at a time? Whenever it feels thirsty, it can drink. No, why it is drinking a lot of water at a time? Because it living in the desert. Okay, desert is a place where is the food and water shortage. Whenever they feel thirsty, they are not able to drink water because there is a scarcity of water. So what it will do whenever it find water, it drink a large quantity of water. Okay, how much liter of water it will drink in a day? See, the adult thirsty camel can drink 200 liters of water in a day. How much liters of water in a day it will drink? 200 liters of water in a day it will drink. Which one? The thirsty camel. Okay, then they have hump to store fat. Okay, camels have hump. Okay, which the hump is place for storage of fat. Okay, it is not storing water in the fat and the hump. They are storing the fat in their hump. Okay, whenever why you want to store fat? Because they are living in the food shortage area, that is desert. Okay, so in the desert, food also shortage. Whenever it is going for long journey, that time the stored fat is gives energy to used by the camel to get energy. Okay, so while using that fat from the hump size get reduced. Okay, while using the fat from the hump size get reduced. Okay, again it will regain the size by eating the food. Okay, the hump size they come to normal by eating the food. Okay, understood. So they have come to store the fat. Okay, next one, next adaptation is camel have thick skin and thick lips. Why they have thick skin? The thick skin protect the camel from the heat. Okay, it is very hot climate now. Okay, in order to escape from the hot climate, they have thick skin. Then why they have thick lips? See, they are living in the desert. So the desert is a place there where thorny plants or cactus will grow. Okay, if they eat the thorny plants, they will make some injury. Okay, in order to prevent that injury, they have thick lips. Understood? Then, if you see that camel, they never sweat. Okay, why they never sweat? If they sweat, the water level in the body gets reduced. So their camels not sweat. Then next one is they will eliminate the urine in very very little amount. Okay, in order to save the water, because they live in the water shortage area. Understood? These are the adaptation followed in the desert animals, and that means camel. Okay, next one, kangaroo rat and lizard. They are also lives in burrows. Okay, why they want to live in burrows? Because they live in the desert. Desert is a very 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 hot during day. Okay, so in order to escape from the hot, okay, they in order to escape from the heat, they live in the burrow in the daytime. Okay, during the night time only they come out from the burrow to search for food. Okay, so the desert lizard they don't want more water. Okay, why they don't want more water? Because they get the water from the food. Understood? So desert lizard and the kangaroo rat lives in the burrows. Okay, why they are living in the burrows? To escape from the heat of the sun. Only night time only they will come out from the burrows to in search of food. Understood? The next one is desert lizard. Okay, desert lizard also lives in burrows to escape from the heat of the sun during the daytime. So if you see the desert lizard, they have one special adaptation. Okay, what is that adaptation means? They will drop the tail off whenever it is chased by a predators. Okay, any animal chases the lizard, they will drop the tail. Okay, to divert the predators or in order to escape from the predators. Understood? Okay, next one is adaptation in forest animals. What is the next topic? Adaptation in forest animals. Forest is the home for many plants and animals. Different kinds of plants and animals live in the forest. Okay, what's my predators? Predators are nothing but organism eats other organisms. What's my predators? Organism which eats the other organism. Next one, prey. What's my prey? Organism which eats the which the predator eat. What's my prey? Organism which the predator eat. I have written one name here. What is this one? Lion. Lion is a predator. Okay, it eats the deer. Okay, deer is the prey for the lion. Okay, lion hunted, chased and hunt the deer. So deer is the food for lion. Here lion is the predator. Predator and deer is a prey. Understood or not? Okay, so predator is nothing but organism eat other organisms. Is called predators. Prey means organism which the predators eat. Okay, deer is eaten by the lion. Here lion is the predators. Deer is the prey. Okay, so many animals depend on other animals for their food. Do you know carnivores now? What is my carnivores? Animals that eat other animals are called carnivores. Here, deer is a herbivore. What's my herbivore? Animal which eats the plant. Okay, animals eat only plant is called herbivore. Okay, deer is a herbivore. It is deer is eaten by the lion. Okay, so deer is a prey. Lion is a predator. Understood. So if you see that carnivorous animals, they have sharp canines. Okay, to tear the flesh. If you see that herbivorous animals, they have wide, flat, grinding teeth to chew the food properly. Understood? Okay, next one is camouflage. Okay, what is my camouflage? Camouflage is the method of hiding in the surroundings by changing physical appearance is called camouflage. Best example is chameleon. What is the best example for camouflage animal? Chameleon. Chameleon shows the camouflage. Okay, when it is threatened by the predators, it changes body color according to their surrounding. Okay, when the chameleon is threatened by a predators, okay, or enemies, okay, they change their body color according to their surrounding. For example, if a chameleon is sitting on the leaves, it changes body color into green. Okay, so the enemies cannot easily identify the chameleon. Okay, if it is sitting on the tree, the chameleon color changes into brown. Okay, so the enemies cannot easily identify. So they will easily escape from the enemies. Understood? One more animal, tiger. We know tiger, no? So if you see the tiger, they have black stripes on their body, on their yellow orange color body. Okay, yellow orange color skin. Which that skin helps the tiger to hiding behind the tall grass. Okay, this is in that color is blend with the grass. So they easily chase the prey and it will hunt and eat. Understood or not? So this is the camouflage. This is the meaning of camouflage. If you see the forest, some insects also live in the forest. Okay, they mimic their surroundings. What's my mimic their surroundings means? They will change their, they will resemble their surroundings. For example, leaf insect and stick insect. These insects change their body size and shape according to their surroundings. If they look like a stick, like a twig. Okay, they change their body shape like a twig. So enemies cannot easily identify. They will easily escape from their enemies. Understood? So what are the topics you have learned today? So today you learned about the adaptation in desert animals. Okay, camel is called sheep of the desert. Okay, camel have thick eyebrows and long eyelashes that prevent the sand entering into their eyes. Then they can close their nostrils that prevent the sand from entering the nose. So camels have long legs that keep the camel away from hot sand. Camel have padded feet. That padded feet help the camel to walk easily on the sand without sinking in the sand. Okay. Camels drink large amount of water at a time. Okay. Yeah, adult thirsty camel can drink 200 liters of water in a day. Then they have hump to store fat. Okay. They will store the extra fat in their hump. Whenever they need, they use the fat to get energy. Then they have thick skin and thick lips. Okay. The thick skin helps the camel to escape from the heat. Thick lips help the animal to eat the thorny plants. Then adaptation in forest animals. If you see the adaptation, first one, predators. Predators are nothing but organisms eat other organisms. Example, lion. Okay, lion is the predator. Okay, next one, prey. right, nothing but organism which the predator eat. Example, deer. So lion is there. Lion is a predator for deer. Okay. See, the deer is eaten by lion. Here lion is the predator. Deer is the prey. Next one, camouflage. So camouflage is the method of hiding in the surrounding by changing physical appearance is called camouflage. Best example, chameleon. Okay. Chameleon change their body color to escape from their enemies. Okay. Understood. The next one, tiger. Tiger also. So the tiger skin color matches with the dried grass.